Christ.
Glory to God forever.
This morning's parable tells us, the Lord says, the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God, is like a man leaping to go far away. The man is the Lord Jesus Christ. His journey to a far country refers to this holy Pascha, when he leaves this world to go to the kingdom of his Father, which is truly far, far away. Let's play like we're on Johnny Carson. How far away is it, Father? It's so far away. It's not anywhere in the world. It's not anywhere in the farthest reaches of space that one could get to theoretically by spaceship. It's not anywhere in this creation, whether seen or unseen. It is altogether beyond this world, beyond earth and sky, far beyond the sun, moon, and stars. So far, that even if you travel from end to end of the universe, from now to eternity, you'd never get there. And yet, if one knows how, one can get there this very day, this very hour, this very minute. In our gospel lesson for last Wednesday, the Lord told us how. Deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me. That is to say, love me because love you. The answer to our riddle is another riddle. This land far away that the Lord is going to is nowhere in the world or in the universe, because the whole universe, from end to end, from side to side, from top to bottom, the whole universe is on this side of the grave. The land that the Lord is going to is on the other side of the grave. Actually, the land that the Lord is going to is beyond even the other side of the grave. Because the land he's going to is beyond even the place of the dead. Beyond hell. Beyond even the Elysian fields. This is the land of the uncreated God. And of uncreated eternal life. And there's only one path that gets you there, and there's but one vehicle. The path is the Lord Jesus Christ himself, his very body and blood. And the vehicle is a certain chariot we come upon a number of times in the Old Testament, in Elijah, for example, the prophet Ezekiel. That chariot is, again, the body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. There is a door that opens onto the path that goes to this land far away, on the other side of the grave, and on the other side of the other side of the grave. But it too is nowhere in the world. It's in the tomb of the Lord's Pascha. Which means that God must himself become flesh. He must become flesh so that he can die and be buried. For he alone can roll away the stone in the tomb to reveal within our own soul the door that opens onto the better and changeless path that ascends to this land of the uncreated kingdom of the Father that is far away within you. I want you to catch the full force of this journey to a far country, and you may be suddenly struck by the joy the Lord is revealing to us in this parable of the talents. This land is impossibly far away. It's impossible for us to get there by our own wisdom or resources. The Lord says it's easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle, which means it's impossible this, we may begin to feel the force of the joy in this parable. For this man, it says, called his own servants. This man called his own servants. Knowing that this man is Jesus Christ, he recognized his own servants to be those who have united themselves to him through holy baptism. And it says, and here's where the translation becomes rather important, and our translation that I just read this morning misses it completely. It says, he gave to them his substance. That's he gave to them his substance. The Greek here can mean wealth or goods or property. It can mean that. So some of the versions will translate it like that. It's also a very philosophical, theological word. It can also mean one's very being, to mean existence. But it's the verb, he gave, that gives us to know immediately that the substance of this man, the Lord Jesus Christ, gives to his own servants is his own body and blood. But the verb is Eucharistic. I received from the Lord, says St. Paul, what I gave to you, same verb. But on the night he was betrayed, he took bread and a cup and said, this is my body, this is my blood. So what the man, the Lord Jesus Christ, gave to his own servants, as he was preparing to go far away, was his own being, his own deified body and blood. He gave himself. He gave to them the Holy Eucharist of the Church, his body and his blood. And if this place that he's going to far away is in our own heart, then in going far away, the Lord Jesus is, in fact, drawing very near to us. In the Latin, this verb, he gave, comes from Providence. Providence. This helps us to see that the tradition of the Church is the Lord Jesus Christ's own body and blood. So then, is the tradition of the Church a handing down of the faith, or is it more properly understood as a calling people to the faith? And is the faith handed down a body of doctrines and practices that differentiate us from others as Orthodox? Or is it the awakening of our soul's innate love for the only lover of mankind, the true and eternal God, giving himself to us in his body, the Church? We have found the true faith. We sing after receiving Holy Eucharist. We have found him whom our soul truly loves. The talents that the Lord gives to each of his own servants from out of his own substance, his own body and blood, now come into view as the heavenly Spirit whom we have received in Holy Eucharist. So these talents are uncreated rays of the uncreated light that we have seen with the eyes of our soul through faith, through our love, Christ. There are the light that shines in the darkness of this world, to illumine within the darkness of our own body and soul, the better and changeless path. The Lord Jesus Christ himself, who has ascended to this far country that is deep within us. There are the uncreated energies of glory that fill the world, and would transfigure our own body and soul, if we would receive them and work them, as the parable affirms that they do. So now feel the force of the joy our Lord proclaims in this parable. In the Old Covenant, the faithful looked to God to give them their inheritance in the form of land. But in the New Covenant, the inheritance that the Lord gives to us sinners is Himself, in His own body and blood. In the Old Covenant, by the blood of bulls and goats, one became righteous by observing the law. In the New Covenant, by the blood of Jesus, we become gods, sons of the Most High, by partaking of the divine nature in Holy Eucharist. It says, He gave talents to each one according to his own strength. That is, I think, according to how much we desire Him, how much we love Him. But whether He gives us much or little, He gives to each one of us the same heavenly Spirit. And therefore, even one talent will grow in us if we work it, to transfigure our body and soul bit by bit, talent by talent, until we become each one all light and all life, each of us a member of Christ's body, and His blood the eternal life that lives in each of us. So now, what if we read our epistle this morning as a manual for growing the talent of the Heavenly Spirit that we have received in Holy Eucharist? Each of these things that St. Paul lists, compassion, kindness, lowliness, meekness, and patience, do they not suddenly come into view, each one as a talent of the Heavenly Spirit? When we clothe ourselves with any one of them, we are putting on Christ. And so you cannot clothe yourselves with any one of them without clothing yourselves in all of them. And when we clothe ourselves in any one of them, we are continuing to be baptized into Christ. And so we are now ourselves going with the Lord on a journey far away. For in the Lord, we are drawing near the door in our own heart, the door that opens onto this path that ascends to this far country. That is within us. These talents are not mine. They are the uncreated energies of God. We receive them, each of us, in accordance with our desire for the Lord. My desire may be little. I may be strong enough only for half a talent. If I work that talent, it will double. And it will double again. My desire too will double, because my desire is receiving Him whom my soul truly loves. And as the talent grows in me, I become less and less conformed to this world that is passing away, and more transformed by the renewing of my mind in the new man, in the knowledge of the icon, Christ Himself, who created me. Or we could bring in Psalm chapter 25, verse 14 here, quoting from Romans chapter 12. We are more and more transformed by the renewing of my mind in the new man, in the intimacy with the icon of Christ. That's from Psalm chapter 25. The Lord, what does it say? The Lord is intimate to those who fear Him. And His covenant, Holy Eucharist, is to reveal Himself to them in the intimacy of the heart's bridal chamber and the love of God. St. Paul also is telling us in this morning's epistle how to work the talent that we receive in Holy Eucharist. He says, forbear one another. As the Lord has forgiven you, so you also, he says, must forgive. It's not an option. You want to work the talent, you must forgive as you have been forgiven. Above all things, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony, in perfect beauty, because that's what harmony is, beauty. And let the peace of Christ, let the peace of Christ, not the anger of men, rule in your hearts. And be thankful, he says, that is to say, be Eucharistic. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom. Sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, he says. Well, what's the music going through your head, brothers and sisters? The latest theme song, the latest movie? That's what's going to be shaping you guys. That's what's going to conform you to the world. You'll be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Fill your mind with songs and hymns and spiritual songs. Sing songs and hymns and spiritual songs, says St. Paul, with thankfulness in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, he says, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks. Again, he says, giving thanks. That is to say, being Eucharistic. But now you should understand, being Eucharistic also means giving yourself, body and soul, to God the Father, to Christ our Lord, who has given himself, body and blood, to us. But if we have received the Lord's substance in his own body and blood, then perhaps the greatest talent he has given to us, each one of us, every single one of us, is the one talent of his own living presence with us here on this side of the grave, so that in his church, his body, even here, we are with him there, in the far country of his Father's kingdom, of uncreated and eternal life. So let's not bury this talent, this one talent. Let's not bury it. This mystery of God who is Christ in us. Let's work it in our souls and love for him, who is the beauty and goodness our soul longs for.